Aimee Nolte. Some questions you can ask them.
Over the meadows, through the rain, the blossom covered lane, and in your lonely flight, have you heard the music in the night? Wonderful music makes fade as the will of the wisp. As a gypsy serenading the moon over the skyline. Don't know if you can find these things, but my heart is riding on your wings. So if you see them anywhere, won't you leave? Thank you.
It's called Soul Minor.
Thank you. tunes. We had never played together. We ran it real quick in sound check, but we didn't talk about dynamics at all. And so in this kind of moment, I needed to pay good attention to what he did to try to, you know, try to feel that. And I think that's pretty easy to do when there's just two of you. There's not too much to pay attention to. I can just focus on Mike, and that makes it easy to morph in, you know, certain sections of songs that we didn't even plan on. But I think paying really good attention to each other is, that's a key.
So I guess my question actually kind of complements that. When you're writing arrangements, initially say you had an arrangement for like a larger combo or something, how do you go about like breaking it? Like, do you write your arrangements for like a duo set, or like do you like maintain like the feel and vibe of an arrangement that you wrote for a larger group and just like change it to like fit the setting, or how do you approach that?
I think it's you know, one, it's, well, particularly with duo, it's like, it's tricky, but it's easy to like work with Aimee because she's sort of, you know, we're both like listening and hearing it. Is that, but you're asking more, so how do you change something? Like, you wrote something for a quartet, now how do you, I feel like at least with these, we're not changing, like, sometimes I might play more active. I mean, obviously there's a drummer and there's a bass player, like, I might be a little more active, like even on when we did the whole Double Moon, like that's probably, like when we were playing it right now, that's probably more than I would normally play in terms of like, you know, comping and strumming and stuff.
Yeah, it's a good comment. Yeah. Just if there are less of you, then in order to get the kind of dynamic contrast that you get in a big group, one or both of you are going to have to be more active in some way.
Like, you might not do that. Like, if we had a bass player, you might not play that bass.
No, I never would.
She might just be playing chords. So a lot of times, when it, you know, when we to transfer, it just becomes sort of like, oh, we don't have the drummer, so I need to like sort of add a little more active.
I've been thinking about this a lot lately, because somebody asked me how to prepare to go into the studio to record, and my greatest answer is to imagine. So like, even this, I just try to take a little time where nothing's going on and imagine my way through the set. What might happen, what might be questions that arise that we need to answer before we even start? Are there places in my arrangements that need any tweaking? And if I just kind of think my way through every tune, chances are I'll answer those questions as they come up, but taking that second to just imagine, I think it's really important. Okay, maybe we should play again?
Yeah.
Who knows where or when? My romance doesn't have to have moon in the sky. My romance doesn't need a blue lagoon standing by. No month of May do. doesn't need a blue lagoon standing by. No other babe, no soft guitar. Doesn't need a castle rising in Spain, nor a dance to a constantly surprise.